this is arising if you have got a copy of the Star paper today. It's a very serious matter. Logging in Ulu Muda catchment. Here we are talking about not enough water, and now we got a report, evidence, the amount of logging being carried out in Ulu Muda catchment. Okay, is the TC press statement being issued? This press statement is issued under my name, not CM's name. Now, as you know, this Ulu Muda catchment, it stretches from Yala in the north to Baling in the south, up to the Thai border. It is 160,000 hectares and is twice the size of Singapore. Why the Ulu Muda catchment is important? Because it is a source of raw water for northern Malaysia. It supplies 96% of Kedah water supply, more than 80% of Penang water supply, and about 50% of Perlis. And it also supplies irrigation water for Kedah. It has a high biodiversity value, and it is one of the critical engines of economic growth in Kedah and Penang. So the threat when you allow logging in the catchment is that the quality and the quantity of the raw water will be degraded. The quality and quantity will be degraded. And in the long run, it will disturb the microclimate within the water catchment area. It will disrupt the ability of the forest to absorb and retain rainwater, and as a result, it can have more frequent floods because there is no retention. When you cut the trees, there are no roots. When the rain falls, it will immediately go down to the low-lying areas and cause flooding. Now, in the report, also mentioned that Kedah is doing logging because they want to earn some fast money. This issue has been brought up by PBA not once, many times. Even in 97-98, when they want to do helicopter logging, where PBA objected. And again recently, when they had a new Menteri Besar, the previous past person, again they want to do helicopter logging, we objected. And it has been brought up to the cabinet, and actually the Malaysian cabinet have instructed them to gazette the catchment area. So we do not understand why this is still going on. If you see, from 2009, they have been issuing licenses for logging. This is legal logging. Now, there must be no logging in a water catchment, for whatever reason. The income that they get is pittance compared to the economic activity in Kedah and Penang. They are earning between 30 to 50 million ringgit a year. That is nothing to the disaster that can befall to Penang and Kedah, where the combined GDP of Penang and Kedah is 135 billion. So what is 30 to 50 million compared to 135 billion? So, PBAPP is also asking the National Water Resources Council the Minister of NRE, the Minister of Qatar, and SPAN to be proactive and advise Kedah against logging in the catchment. Yeah? And if it is not stopped, then the source, the beginning of water supply in the northern region will be jeopardized. This El Nino have already shown that there is not enough water, because until today, the Muda Dam and the Beris Dam is at critical level. And the rain that you are having now is needed. More of it is needed, because we need to build up the storage to get ready for next year's dry season. As I repeatedly say, that you have to fill up the dams by the end of the year. If not, next year's dry season will be worse than this year. Yeah? Okay? And we hope that the federal authorities will be able to advise Kedah to stop this dangerous and disastrous business venture. Simple, I repeat. What is the income of 30 to 50 million versus 135 billion? Okay? And once you disturb the catchment, it is very difficult for the catchment to recover. Why? Because the microclimate is affected. Yeah? I've always said the trees are important in the catchment to help the clouds reach the dew point. That's when the clouds become rain. And if you are logging, then less and less areas of the catchment can help to generate the rain. Consequently, you have less rain, even during the rainy season. And the worst case scenario is you have clouds, but you have no rain, because the microclimate has changed. Okay? Any questions? So for PBA, this is very shocking. This is the last thing that we want. Logging in a water catchment area. That's why we have been pushing, not only in Kedah, but all the states in Malaysia. All the catchment must be gazetted as a catchment area. Then only you can protect. If you don't gazette it as a catchment area, you cannot protect the catchment. After you gazette, you have to make sure it is enforced. And this is totally illogical to allow logging in the catchment. Yeah? Again, I repeat, what is 30 to 50 million versus 135 billion? Yeah?
The current level of water in our dams could be the effect of this logging instead of El Nino?
No, it's a combination. The El Nino will make it worse.
Okay.
As I've mentioned, water supply in Penang will only be okay when the dams in Penang reach 60% and above. Right now, it's 50%. We are getting rain, but it must build up the dam. At the same time, the Sungai Muda dams, which is Muda Dam and Beris Dam, they should be filled up to about 50%. They are now 30%. So we still got 20% for the Muda and Beris Dam to be filled up. And for Penang Island dams, it is 10%. So we hope the rains that is coming will be able to build it up, okay, in the next 1 or 2 months. Okay.
So will it affect quality of potable water right now?
The quality of potable water, for instance, on the island, you will see our raw water quality is like spring water. We do not need to spend a lot of money to treat the water because it's spring water. But the water from Sungai Muda, if you take the North-South Highway, you can see when you pass by, it is teh tarik. Why is it teh tarik? Because of this logging. Okay? So, of course, the quality of the raw water deteriorates, but engineers, I told you, can treat anything. The issue here is the cost. So, therefore, it costs more money to treat water from Sungai Muda than to treat water on the island. Okay? When the water is of a lower quality, you need more chemicals to treat it. Yeah? And you also notice the taste will be different. Yeah? Okay?
So what's the federal government agencies related to water? Aware of the wrongdoing?
I have no idea. But my purpose today is to make them aware. I hope you all report it very big, just like what Star did. Because this is very, very important. Yeah? The federal agencies must take proper action. This should not happen. And it's happening since 2009. So you think how long can the catchment tahan this kind of abuse? Once Mother Nature decides not to help you, you'll be in trouble. When is that? When the clouds come and not much rainfall. Yeah? And the whole northern region will suffer. Yeah? Okay? So the federal agencies have to wake up and do their part. Like I mentioned just now, the National Water Resources Council, the Minister of NRE, the Minister of Qatar, and SPAN, yeah, who have the jurisdiction to advise Kedah State. The issue here, what PBA wants to tell everybody is that there must be no logging in a water catchment for whatever reason. Yeah? Okay. And the Muda catchment must be gazetted as a water catchment area so that the appropriate laws can be utilized to protect it and prevent activities that are not beneficial for a water catchment. Thank you very much.